Well, at Chester College, they normally have about 200 students, but that number dropped by about 25% in recent years, making it difficult for them to stay afloat.
Just too good to fail, and there is a possibility of closure.
Laura Ives is the Vice President of Academic Affairs and Student Services at Chester College of New England. She says the small liberal arts college nestled in Chester is in serious financial trouble because when the recession hit, enrollment dropped.
I would say probably 2009 and 2010, we got hit hard with parents who are unable to afford to have their kids to go to school, so our enrollment dipped a little bit.
Now they need more than $500,000 by next month in order to open their doors to students again next fall. If the school is forced to close, they will have to place their current students at other colleges. Now students, faculty, and staff are desperately trying to raise money to keep the school open nearly 50 years ago, alive for another 50. So far, they've raised about $4,000.
The writers who've been here, absolutely. Alumni who are writers, absolutely. They've been writing in, they've been donating money.
That students at this college have volunteered to take their scholarships and give it to the college.
Students at Chester College say the school provides small classrooms and a unique college experience that you don't find at larger universities, and they don't want to see it go.
Day one, the faculty was actually interested in me and my work, and they asked me, you know, where are you from? How are you doing? Let me see some of that. Oh, I can do a critique for you.
Now, if you want more information about Chester College and their fundraising efforts, you can check them out on our website, WMUR.com, and click on the As Seen On section. Reporting live, Jennifer Gannon, WMUR News 9.